Fitzpatrick and David Ruckman, experts on the American woman, past and present. Lee Pedicini and Marge Dealey competing in the game of golf. Caldwell, compete in general knowledge. On NBC's biggest putting program, the 50 Grand Slam. And here's the star of the program, Tom Kennedy.
Hello there. Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 50 Grand Slam, where people compete in a series of physical and mental events that require both skill and daring, risking everything they have every step of the way until one of them wins the money and the other goes home with no money at all. Now, a person with the courage to take that risk can go from $200 all the way up to $50,000.
I love the rules. I need the rules of the game. Do you like rules? I dig rules. Well, I've got some for you in a minute, but before you go, you watch him every day on Stumpers here on NBC.
And if all of your fans watch this show, we got to be a hit.
We're together, back to back.
You bet. Now, wait a minute. If you pass the store on the way home, would you give me a couple of dozen light bulbs? Thank you, Alan. Yeah. Alan Ludden, ladies and gentlemen. Alan, you watch the rules. We've got rules, and we also have contestants. And I walk right up here, and I say, ladies and gentlemen, our first event is a competition between experts in the category The American Woman, Past and Present. Our competition will continue until nine authorities have competed, or until one of them has had the opportunity to win $50,000. Our competitors have been selected at random. And so, John Harlan, would you introduce our first two experts, please?
Tom, we have a Ph.D. in United States history concerned with progressive movements and social reform. She's taught for several years as professor of American history at Los Angeles University, Sister Martha Ann Fitzpatrick. And a graduate student, a teacher. He's concentrated his interest in the field of American women's history and is now writing the last chapter of his doctoral dissertation, David Ruckman.
Well, I'll talk to you first, David. Welcome aboard, sir, first of all.
Thanks a lot.
You're working on your doctoral thesis, are you?
Right.
How long does that take?
More than I'd like it to.
Really?
Really.
Step up to the microphone a little bit more.
Sure.
Are you married, David?
Yes, I am.
All right. Any children?
No children.
Okay. All right, now let's talk to its sister, Martha Ann Fitzpatrick. Thanks. Happy to have you
Thank
on the show.
You very much.
You're welcome. Now, how long have you been a sister?
28 years.
You're obviously very happy in your work.
Oh, I am.
Where did you teach, sister?
Well, I'm teaching right now at Loyola Marymount University in Los Angeles.
Very good. There's one of your students right there. I'm her fan. Okay, sister? And David, welcome to both of you. And you folks, stay with us and see how you do against the experts right after this. All right, welcome back to our expert competition in the category of American Woman. Now, the first step on the way to a 50 grand slam is worth $200. Now, to win, you must answer at least two questions correctly. If you tie, you're committed to continue the competition until one of you wins the money. And by the way, all questions on our program are selected at random. And a flip of the coin determined that you, sister, are going to step into our soundproof booth. David, you're going to start our competition, so sister, step right over here. Sister Martha Ann Fitzpatrick, we have a new home for you for the next few seconds. Thank you very much there, Judy. All right. Hello there, Debbie. Thank you. These are the first questions. Thank you very much. All right. Now, David, first of all, could we turn the sound off in the booth, please? The sound is off. First of all, here is an explanation. Throughout history, women have made an enormous contribution to the written word. This four-part question is about some of these literary ladies. Are you ready, David?
I hope so.
Here's your first question. She has accomplished a great deal in our modern pop culture, but she will be best remembered as the woman who gave the world the first male nude centerfold in a respectable magazine, and as the author of Sex and the Single Girl. Who is she?
Helen Gurley Brown.
You're right. Off and running, you have one out of four. You have a total of four questions. Here's your second question. This author is most famous for her plays, The Little Foxes and Another Part of the Forest. More recently, she published two books of memoirs, Pentimento and Scoundrel Time. What is her name?
Lillian Hellman.
Right again. You have two right. Here's the next question. This woman was a tastemaker for 38 years in her position as editor-in-chief of Vogue magazine. She once said, fashion can be bought, style one must possess. Who was this famous editor?
That I don't know.
No answer. All right, the answer is Edna Woolman Chase. So you have two out of three. If you folks at home are hearing any music right now, it's coming from the booth over here, from Sister's booth. Now, here's your final question. And her play, Any Wednesday, was the toast of Broadway as it explored the triangle between a man, his wife, and his mistress, and it made a star of Sandy Dennis. Who is the author of Any Wednesday?
That I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
No answer. The answer is Muriel Resnick, and so you got two out of four, David. Very good. And now, we're going to go over here to Sister Martha Ann Fitzpatrick, and we're going to turn the sound on. First of all, is the sound on? Can you hear me, Sister Martha
Ann?
Yes,
I can.
Good. You can hear me clearly.
Yes.
All right. I'm going to tell you right now that David Ruckman, we have four questions, and he gave me two correct answers. Now, you need two to tie. You need three to win. First of all, here's a little preamble I want you to listen to. Are you ready, Sister Martha Ann? Can you still hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Good. All right. Throughout history, women have made an enormous contribution to the written word. Now, this four-part question is about some of these literary ladies. Here is your first question. She has accomplished a great deal in our modern pop culture, but she will be best remembered as the woman who gave the world the first male nude centerfold in a respectable magazine, and as the author of Sex and the Single Girl. Who is she? You have 5 seconds.
Helen Gurley Brown.
That's right. Yes, sir. One out of one. Here's your second question. This author is most famous for her plays, The Little Foxes and Another Part of the Forest. More recently, she published two books of memoirs, Pentimento and Scoundrel Time. What is her name? You have 5 seconds. Time. Her name, Lillian Hellman. One out of two. You need one more for a tie. Here's your third question. This woman was a tastemaker for 38 years in her position as editor-in-chief of Vogue magazine. She once said, fashion can be bought, style one must possess. Who was this famous editor? You have 5 seconds. The answer, Edna Woolman Chase. This is your fourth and final question. You need it for a tie. Her play, Any Wednesday, was the toast of Broadway as it explored the triangle between a man, his wife, and his mistress, and it made a star of Sandy Dennis. Who is the author of Any Wednesday? You have 5 seconds. David Ruckman is our champ. The answer, Muriel Resnick. All right, sister, we'll invite you out of the booth now. Come on over here, sister. Muriel Resnick was the last one. You had only one answer. You, David, had two correct answers, and so I'm sorry we had to say goodbye to you, but it was a real pleasure meeting you, Sister Martha Ann, and we have a nice gift for you, and thank you very much
thank
for playing.
Thank you very
for...
much.
Well, you're welcome. It was a pleasure meeting you. Thank you very much. David, congratulations. All right. You have now won $200, which, of course, is yours to keep, or you can risk it against a new challenger in an attempt to go not for $200 next time, but for $500. So come back on tomorrow's program and give us your decision. Will you do that, David?
You bet.
All right. We'll look forward to seeing you then. Thank you very much, David Ruckman. Yes, that's it. Thank you, David. See you tomorrow. And now, ladies and gentlemen, today we begin a competition between two golfers. Not experts, but weekend athletes with high handicaps. And so, John Harlan, would you introduce them, please?
Tom, our first contestant, is a lady who's been playing golf for 20 years. She plays an average of 2 days a week, has an 18 handicap. Please welcome Lee Pettacini. And she'll be competing against a lady who's been playing golf for 16 years, plays an average of 1.5 days a week. She has a handicap of 16. Welcome Marge Dealey.
All right. What do you say you were, a 10 handicap, Marge?
I wish I was.
How many times a week do you get out?
About 1.5.
Is that right? Married?
Yes.
How about you, Lee Pettacini? Married?
Yes.
How many times a week do you get out?
Oh, a couple times.
That's good. That's not bad. All right. Now, here's what we're going to do. We're going to give you two ladies a chance to compete against each other for $200, which, of course, is our very first level. And we're going to do that and see if you can pick the right one. We'll find out who the winner is right after this. All right, welcome back to our golf competition. This is Marge Dealey, and this is Lee Pettacini, and now you're both playing for $200, and if you'll follow me, I'll show you how you can win it. Come on, right this way. Here's our little luxurious golf course up here. Marge and Lee, come on up here, if you will, please. Incidentally, a flip of the coin determined that Lee is going to go first. Now, I want you to both understand that we have a target right over here for you. That is 25 feet from us. That is a 5-foot diameter tub. You will each have 5 balls. You must put, or rather chip, the ball into the tub on the fly. Now, to advance, 2 out of 5 balls must go into that tub, and the player chipping the most balls into the tub wins. And no bounce-ins count. But if the ball goes in but bounces out, that is considered in. Okay, now, a flip of the coin, as I said that you go first, Lee. So pick your club, if you will, please. And we'll... Now, I want you, Marge, to come over here with me. You step up there, Lee. She's looking at it. She's eyeing it up. She knows it's 25 feet. And Marge, you and I will come back here and watch her. All right. On to this way. Oh, just a little high. Just a little high. Made good connection. Came into it well, huh, Lee? She has a slight forward press, and into the tub it goes. 1 out of 2. 3 more to go. A little high, so she has 1 out of 3. 2 balls remaining. There's a slight forward press there. Very good style, Early. That's the 4th one, and she hit right on the rim. She has 1 ball so far. You need 2 to win the money. Final ball coming up. Oh, she undercut it a little bit. All right, Marge, you have your work cut out for you.
Yes, I do.
You saw Lee put in 1 out of 5. Lee puts her club back in there. Okay, come on over here, Lee. Looks easy, doesn't it? Plays tough. It doesn't? I thought it looked easy, but it doesn't play that well. Okay, now here... Oh, that was very close there, Marge, but you missed. A little high, a little bit to the right. Yes, that's right. That's her 2nd ball. She missed a little bit to the left. As you saw, you need 1 to tie Lee. You need 2 to win. She has 3 balls left, folks. This is the 3rd ball coming up here. This is actual grass, folks, with actual sod. This is not an artificial turf. Oh, very close, but no cigar. A little low. If you can find the in-between, you got something. This is her final ball. She needs it to tie Lee. And she put it in! We have a tie. 1 out of 5 for each of our ladies. Marge Dealey, stay right here with me. We're over here. And Lee Pettacini. Now, here's what happened. You each got 1. I said you need 2 to advance. So you have not earned $200. You need at least 2 balls for that. But you have earned, both of you,
the right to come back and continue this competition. You'll still be at the $200 level, but we'll see you next time we have golf. Are you looking forward to it, Marge?
Oh, I certainly am, Lee? After that show.
And so are we. And, of course, whether you win or lose, no one leaves here empty-handed. John Harlan, tell them what I mean.
We have a Western Auto gift certificate for a Super 8 home movie outfit, camera, and dual 8 projector, redeemable at any of their 4,800 stores furnished by Western Auto. And Clark Gum, two great flavors, two great ways. Teaberry Cinnamon, also now sugar-free. A refreshment and great flavor furnished by Clark Gum. And 20 Duo Power bathroom cleaners, industrial spring. Use it once a week. It wipes out soap, scum, hard water scale, mold, and mildew while it disinfects.
And any contestant who reaches the last step and fails to make a 50 grand slam will win one of these, John.
You bet. That's right, Tom. It's a 77 Chevy Nova, a sporty compact with an interior large enough for six people and the handling of a small car. The size makes it easy to drive and park, and the six-cylinder engine helps save gas. Nova, furnished by Chevrolet. Or the 77 Chevy Vega, built tough with a durable engine, a rugged chassis, and extensive corrosive protection. Vega, furnished by Chevrolet.
Is one in which a little knowledge goes a long way. That is, if you know a little bit about a lot of things. It's the general knowledge competition, and the contestants have to deal with the new subject every single day. John Harlan, would you introduce them, please?
Tom, we have a clothes buyer and homemaker from Cincinnati, mother of two whose interests are golf and interior design, Carolyn Huffaker. And a homemaker and mother of three originally from Tel Aviv. She likes sailing and tennis, Bonnie Caldwell.
Hello, Bonnie. And hello there, Carolyn. Good to see you both. And as I just told the folks at home, this is going to be a general knowledge competition. And you both look pretty general knowledgeable to me. And we'll see how well they do right after these words for you, my friend. All right, welcome back to our competition in the category of general knowledge. We have here Bonnie Caldwell and Carolyn Huffaker. You're competing for $200. I'll ask each of you the same number of questions, namely four. You must answer two correctly to advance and tie, and you both return to compete again. A flip of the coin backstage determined that Bonnie was going to go first. So we're going to take you, Carolyn, and put you in our isolation booth right over here so you won't be able to hear anything that's going on. So there goes Carolyn Huffaker. And here come my questions. Thank you very much. This is general knowledge for you, Bonnie Caldwell. First of all, could we turn the sound off in Carolyn's booth? There it is. And now, are you ready, Bonnie?
Yep.
Here we go. The key to these questions is that all four answers will contain the word stone, S-T-O-N-E. Here's your first question. Who was the hero of the 1861 Battle of Bull Run? 5 seconds.
Bridgestone?
No, it was Stonewall Jackson. Yes. Next question. What word is a synonym for both a shrewish, ill-tempered woman and for sulfur? 5 seconds. Brimstone. You have two left. What is the name given this slab, discovered in 1799, that provided the key to hieroglyphic writing?
Rosetta Stone.
That's it, the Rosetta Stone. One out of three so far. Here's your fourth and final question. Who was the statesman who was the dominant personality of the British Liberal Party in the late 1800s? 5 seconds. That answer, William Gladstone. You got one out of four. All right, let's go over here now and turn the sound on in Carolyn Huffaker's booth. Can you hear me now, Carolyn?
Yes, I can.
I'm going to tell you that your opponent has one correct answer. One out of four. So that means you need one to tie, you need two to win. All right, it's general knowledge, as you know. The key to these questions is that all four answers will contain the word stone, S-T-O-N-E. Here's your first question. Who is the hero of the 1861 Battle of Bull Run? 5 seconds.
William Stone.
No, say it again.
William Stone?
No, it was Stonewall Jackson.
Oh.
Yes, I know. All right, next question. What word is a synonym for both a shrewish, ill-tempered woman and for sulfur? Yeah, 5 seconds. Brimstone.
Oh.
Yes, I know. It's all right. Here's your third question. What is the name given this slab discovered in 1799 that provided the key to hieroglyphic writing? 5 seconds.
The Rosetta Stone. You have one final one. If you answer this correctly, you can tie. Who is the statesman? Who was the dominant personality of the British Liberal Party in the late 1800s? Your answer? You have 5 seconds.
William Stone?
No, it was William Gladstone. All right, Carolyn Huffaker, come on out of the booth. None out of four, but I know. And after you hear, you say, of course. Well, we had to say goodbye to you, Carolyn, but we enjoyed having you on our show. We have a nice gift for you, and thank you for playing 50 Grand Slam, Carolyn Huffaker. Bonnie, congratulations to you. And you had one correct answer, and that's not enough to win the money, but it does earn you the right to come back tomorrow and meet another challenger at the $200 level. Okay, we'll be back right after these few words. If you're interested in becoming a contestant on our show, here's John Harlan to tell you how you can do it.
If you possess above-average knowledge in any of these categories or any of the subjects, send a letter stating your area of specialized knowledge, how you acquired the knowledge. Be sure to include return address, telephone number, or recent photo. Send it to 50 Grand Slam, Post Office Box 5387, Channel Islands, California, 93030.
My friends, join us tomorrow for more competition in American Women, General Knowledge, and a new expert category, American Musical Theater, on NBC's biggest money program, the 50 Grand Slam.
Some of our contestants will receive Adorn Hairspray. It has a unique non-sticky formula that leaves hair feeling touchable. Adorn holds your hair, yet no one knows it's there. Adorn Anonymous. A coffee corner from General Electric. Complete coffee making center for coffee the way you like it every time. From Amity, a ladies' three-piece leather set featuring the checkbook clutch in tool vintage style. Money and check writing all in your grasp. Amity. The Vivitar pocket camera. The flash is built in for sharper pictures. Even when your subject moves, your pictures are sharp. Furnished by Vivitar.